For the entire 15 years since I've been selling water ionizers, there's always been a debate about whether you should drink alkaline water with meals or while taking any type of supplements or pharmaceuticals for fear that the alkaline water may somehow raise the pH of the stomach and therefore make it harder to digest food or possibly reduce the effectiveness of the pills that you're taking. And while that concern is certainly understandable, it may not be so much warranted, especially if we take a look at the science. So that's the question for this week. Does alkaline water from a water ionizer affect stomach acid, and how? Hey guys, I'm Dean Snyder from Snyder Health. Welcome to another episode of Water Ionizer Wednesday, where each Wednesday I'll answer another commonly asked questions about water ionizers that I get from my own customers. Before I get to the answer, I'd like to ask that you hit that red subscribe button and then also hit the notification bell icon because I have new videos coming out each week. And so this way you never miss an episode in this series. So the first thing I want to talk about is stomach acid and describe exactly what makes up stomach acid. Everybody knows that stomach acid is responsible for the initial phases of breaking down food matter so that it can then travel into the intestinal tract where the nutrients can be absorbed. The stomach is also responsible for killing bacteria and other pathogens before they have a chance to enter the body. And it does all that by utilizing chemicals that are created by your body and then sent into the stomach to do their work. When most people think of stomach acid, they automatically think of hydrochloric acid. And although hydrochloric acid is an important component of stomach acid, it's only a small part of the entirety of what makes up what is called gastric juices. Let's take a look at the separate components of gastric juice. We can break down gastric juice into roughly 8 different categories. First, there's the well-known hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid is secreted by the parietal cells of the stomach and is responsible for killing bacteria, viruses, and other pathogens that may be found in your food. Hydrochloric acid is also responsible for breaking down the enzyme pepsinogen into pepsin, which helps to break up proteins into smaller, more easily digested molecules. Next, we have pepsinogen. Pepsinogen is secreted by cells in the stomach and converts into pepsin once it's activated by hydrochloric acid. Pepsinogen breaks down complex proteins into smaller polypeptides and amino acids, which can then be more easily absorbed by the body once they leave the stomach. Then you have gastric lipase, which is an enzyme that breaks down short chain and medium chain fats. Your stomach also contains intrinsic factor, which is necessary for vitamin B12 absorption. Gastric juice also contains hormones and electrolytes, which aid in organ function, food digestion, and nutrient absorption. The hormones are made by different organs of the body and are sent to the stomach by different pathways. Some of those hormones are responsible for things like shutting down the gastric juice process, controlling contractions in the stomach, and for making you feel full once you finish eating. Next, we have amylase. Amylase is an enzyme found primarily in saliva where it acts to break down carbohydrates. It's found in the stomach because you swallow saliva when you swallow your food. Next, we have mucus. Mucus is produced by cells in the mouth, esophagus, and stomach, and is responsible for easing the passage of food through the gastrointestinal tract and protects the lining of the stomach from being attacked by its own acids. And lastly, gastric juice contains water. Water does not affect the pH of the stomach, but it does help to provide enough liquidity that the food enzymes and acids can readily mix together. Also, some of the enzymes that are needed for digestion require water in order to function. So as you can see, hydrochloric acid makes up only a portion of the total contents of the stomach that's required for digestion. And for the most part, not only does water not interfere with most of the chemical processes that are required to break down food, but instead helps digestion by helping to mix together all the food you just ate. But I know what you're thinking. Won't the high pH level of water from an ionizer raise the pH of the stomach and interfere with some of those digestive processes? Well, first we need to understand the nature of the alkaline water that's made by a water ionizer. As I mentioned in a previous video, the terms pH and alkalinity are often used interchangeably, but pH and alkalinity are not the same thing. pH, which stands for potential hydrogen, is a measurement of the amount of hydrogen ions in that water. But when we're talking about water, the term alkalinity refers to the water's ability to resist changes in pH that would make the water more acidic, usually by way of mineral compounds or bicarbonates. Believe it or not, you could actually add substances to water that would raise the alkalinity of water without causing a rise in the pH level. And conversely, you can raise or lower the pH of water without affecting its alkalinity level. Again, alkalinity and pH are two separate things, but are mistakenly used interchangeably. When water from an ionizer goes through electrolysis, the drinking water that's created has a much higher hydroxide concentration and a much lower hydrogen concentration. Therefore, drinking water that has a high pH will not affect the acidity level of the stomach. As a matter of fact, an article from the Molecular Hydrogen Institute states that in order to neutralize 1 liter of stomach acid with a pH of 0, you would need to drink 10,000 liters of water with a pH of 10. So unless you intend to drink a small swimming pool while you're having your meal, there's nothing to worry about. But that drinking water may also contain minerals, carbonates, and bicarbonates, depending on the mineral types and concentrations that exist in your tap water. So if the alkalinity level of the water that comes out of your water ionizer is high, meaning it contains those mineral buffers, then you can indeed temporarily raise the pH level of the gastric juices in the stomach. But here's the catch. When there's food in your stomach, the pH of the gastric juice is between 1.5 and 3.5. Your stomach is very clever. If you ingest any kind of alkaline buffers that would raise the pH of your gastric juice, then your stomach will simply create more hydrochloric acid to bring the pH levels back down to where they need to be. If it didn't do that, then you would never be able to eat and digest any type of alkaline foods, right? And here's the great part about that process. When your stomach creates more hydrochloric acid, it also simultaneously creates bicarbonates that then enter the bloodstream. Bicarbonates in the bloodstream are what's responsible for regulating your body's pH levels by eliminating acids that are created through your everyday normal metabolism. So more bicarbonates equals less acid waste floating around in your body. So folks, hopefully this information dispels the myth that you can't drink alkaline water while you're eating. As a matter of fact, drinking water with your meals, contrary to what you may have heard, is actually good for you. Drinking water while you're eating not only helps to liquefy the food, which will help digestion and nutrient absorption, but will also help prevent constipation by keeping the stool soft and keeping your digestive tract lubricated. It also helps to make you feel fuller, and so this way you won't eat as much food, which is a definite benefit for most people. Hey, listen, if you found this video helpful, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And let me know in the comment section below if you've been avoiding drinking alkaline water with your meals. Make sure to check the description area below for information on how you can save $450 on a brand new 9-plate Vesta H2 water ionizer like the one you see here next to me. And if you haven't done it yet, you can subscribe to the channel by clicking on this big round button right here. And you can watch other videos in the Water Ionizer Wednesday video series by clicking on either one of those right over there. Hopefully I'll see you guys next week. Until then, thanks for watching.